During the Buddha's time, the Sakyan and Kolyan tribes lived on opposite sides of the Rohini River. They both used the river as a source of water to cultivate their crops and in their everyday lives. There was plenty of water and fish, and the two tribes made daily use of the river. However, in May and June, the water began to dry up. Both sides thought, "There is not enough water for both of our tribes to use." So, one side built a dam and claimed the water for themselves. The other clan was upset at this affront and said,
"How dare you claim our river is yours?"
Both sides gathered their armies and began threatening each other with violence. Neither side felt it could afford to give up its claim on the river. Each side felt that its survival and welfare relied on the water, and it could not do without it. Therefore, each side was willing to go to war over it. Each insult compounded the last, leading to stronger insults and threats, and eventually, war appeared imminent. The Buddha, in his infinite compassion, came to the river. Both kings immediately bowed to him and paid their respects. They told the Buddha about what had happened and how they could not reach a compromise. The Buddha then told them, "Strife among kinsfolk is unseemly. Even in the past, animals worked together to avoid certain death. However, when they allowed discord to enter their midst, utter destruction befell them." The kings, wishing to hear the story of the past, invited the Buddha to make clear that which only he could see. Once upon a time, the Bodhisat was born as the leader of a group of thousands of quails. In those days, there was a quail hunter who hunted in that forest. He would set a net high in the trees and would imitate a quail's mating call to get the quails to come together. Once the quails gathered, he would release the net and capture the quails. The quails would all try to fly in different directions, but they all bumped into each other and caused havoc and injury. Thus, none of them were able to escape. The hunter was able to capture all the quails and take them home in order to prepare them to sell. The Bodhisat quail saw how the hunter was able to capture so many of his kinsfolk and called a meeting of the quails. He said to them, "I have a method by which we can prevent the hunter from capturing us. We must work together to succeed. Through teamwork, we can overcome his trap and escape. If you find yourself in the net, do not panic. Each of us should put their head through a hole in the net. Then, we should all fly up in the same direction at the same time. Then, place the net on the high branches, and then fly away from underneath the suspended net." The next day, a group of quails were caught in the hunter's net. However, instead of panicking, they looked to each other and said,
"Let us follow the leader's plan."
Each quail quickly poked their head through a hole, and then they all flew straight up at the same time. When the hunter came to gather his trap, he saw it hanging on a high branch. The quails had flown away safely from underneath it. Thus, the quails were able to perfect this method and avoid the hunter's nets for many days. However, the hunter was not discouraged. He told his wife,
"Don't worry. Once the quails start bickering and fighting, they will lose their harmony and fall prey to me."
And just as the hunter predicted, not too long after that, a quail accidentally stepped on another quail's head. This created arguments, and all the quails took sides. Some said,
"It is only because of us that all are able to escape the nets."
The others said,
"You think you can do it yourself? Without us, you would be trapped."
Each side emphasized its strengths while ignoring its faults, and thus, the quails could find no compromise. The Bodhisat tried to get the two sides to calm down and be reasonable. However, they refused to listen to him. He knew that quarreling and bickering would not lead to a successful outcome. Instead, it would lead to mutually assured destruction. As long as each side thinks that it is right and the other side is wrong, and refuses to see fault in itself, no resolution can be made, and peace will be made impossible. The Bodhisat then led his followers away. Not too long after that, the bickering quails found themselves caught in the net again. Instead of working together to escape, each side blamed the other for its mistakes and failings. Instead of focusing on their collective safety, each group of quails focused on winning the argument. The hunter was easily able to capture all the quails. And thus, the Buddha concluded the Jataka story. The two kings realized their mistakes and worked together to share the water.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.